Hey everybody, it's Gordon Majak here, back with another episode of Timeless Pop, Rock, and Soul. And today I am going to give you about as much soul as you can possibly handle. Now, if you remember here in the last few videos, going back there to Katie Lang and then Amy Winehouse, I shared with you that those two gals, two of my all-time top three female vocalists. Well, this artist that I'm going to share with you today may not be in the top three, but she's an easy top 10 in my all-time favorite female vocalists, and she may be knocking on the door of the top five. She is that good. Who am I speaking of? I think it's best to just, the word that best describes her is legend. Just a legend. And of course, I am talking about the one and only Chaka Khan and her album, Classikhan, featuring the London Symphony Orchestra. Now, this was the original cover for this record. This album came back there in, 2004, Chaka Khan. Classikhan, and she is covering a whole album full of standards on this particular record. But at some point along the way, they updated the cover, and that is the new cover, apparently, for Chaka Khan. What can I say about Chaka Khan? I love me some Chaka Khan, and I go all the way back with her to the beginning of her career there when she first broke through with Rufus. What year was it? 1974. How did you know? I've told you a million times, 1974 was such an epic year for music. And here we go again. 1974 is the year that Rufus and Chaka Khan had their big breakthrough hit, Tell Me Something Good. And I remember hearing that one a lot back there in the day. Now, just very briefly with the Rufus aspect of this before we jump up into Chaka Khan's solo career. Of course, Tell Me Something Good, huge crossover hit back there in 1974. Just a couple other brief highlights for Rufus and Chaka Khan. Of course, you talk about a stone-cold classic slow jam, one of the all-time great soul ballads, the epic Sweet Thing, a top five hit from 1975. And then we jump up there to 1982 and the Rufus and Chaka Khan Stompin' at the Savoy, that great live album that included a couple brand new studio tracks. And one of those brand new studio tracks back there in 1983 was a monster hit for Rufus and Chaka Khan. And of course, that was Ain't Nobody. A number one R&B hit, a number six dance hit, and a number two hit on the pop charts. So just a very few of the highlights from Chaka Khan's career with Rufus. And then we jump over to her solo career. And it's just one great song after another. I'll just read you a couple here of the highlights. 1978, how about I'm Every Woman? That was a classic. 1981, What You Gonna Do For Me was a big hit. 1982, her cover of Got to Be There was great, another big hit. 1984, I Feel For You and Through the Fire, that was a great album. 1992, Love You All My Lifetime was a big hit. And as recently as 1996 there, that great Never Miss the Water from her greatest hits album. I went back and I did not realize this, that Chaka Khan had had so much crossover success on the dance charts. I knew, obviously, she's just an absolute legend in the R&B and soul world, but I didn't really realize how much success she'd had on the dance charts. I counted six number one dance songs. That is no small feat, and certainly speaks to Chaka Khan's crossover appeal there. On the personal side, here's what I will say about Chaka Khan. Just as a little insight into her career, you know, with all of the success that she had crossing over there with both with Rufus and her solo career, I think sometimes with Chaka Khan, you know, if we went back through her catalog and we were to magically change the entire direction of her career. And we were going to go back to the very beginning, and we are going to remove all of the songs in her catalog that fall into that general R&B slash soul or even dance category. And we're only going to keep in her catalog the songs that we could fairly categorize as jazz, because she's done some jazz in her career, right? So if we threw out everything else and just kept the jazz, and considered that there's a spectrum, of course, of jazz, so many subgenres within jazz, and she's played that spectrum. If we were to throw away everything and just keep the jazz, and then give her a different direction from the very beginning of her career, and make her a jazz artist, and she spends her entire career exploring nothing but that spectrum of jazz, what kind of career would Chaka Khan have had? And the reason I ask that is because I think Chaka Khan can fairly be considered, accurately be considered, one of the true giants, one of the real divas that came out, soul divas that came out of that generation of female soul singers there in the 60s and 70s. And you think of names, certainly Aretha Franklin, Gladys Knight, Patti LaBelle, Chaka Khan. Those are the names that I think you most commonly would hear as the real giants of the female soul singers of that time. Well, if we were to do as I'm suggesting and going back through Chaka Khan's career and her catalog and make her a jazz singer, is there any doubt that she wouldn't also be considered one of the top five, six, or seven jazz singers of all time? I mean, if you think of Ella Fitzgerald and Sarah Vaughan and Dinah Washington and Billie Holiday and maybe another or two, isn't Chaka Khan like right there as one of the great jazz singers? I think she is. And it's twofold. It's number one, there's that voice, right? I mean, that voice is just such a magnificent instrument. And again, it's the chops. I mean, Chaka Khan has got chops for days. But that voice, what a powerhouse. And you can't even really describe it just in only very limited terms, her voice, because she can cover such a range. And there are so many nuances and subtleties to her singing. And that's why when I think of Chaka Khan, as I said, despite all this incredible success in the world of pop, R&B, soul, dance music, when I think of Chaka Khan in my mind and I hear that voice in my head, I hear a jazz singer. Plain and simple. And I wish I could meet her or talk to her or interview her, and I would tell her that, and I'd be curious to see what her response is. I hear a jazz singer. There is a jazz singer inside Chaka Khan. And I think her love of jazz, her mastery of the improvisational, various improvisational techniques and the spontaneity that I think is associated with the best jazz singers, her ability to just twist and turn things and put so many different colors into her vocals, that's a jazz thing. And that's not something that just pop rock or soul singers generally tend to have. It's really almost a skill in itself, but it's a mindset too. And speaking of mindset, is there anything you think about Chaka Khan? And when I think of Chaka Khan, it's juice. Chaka Khan, throughout her career, sometimes her material is incredible. Other times her material, I don't think, is up to the level of her talent and up to her artistry. But be that as it may, one thing you can always say about Chaka Khan is she brings the fire, she brings the passion, she brings the juice. You never listen to a Chaka Khan vocal and think, well, she wasn't into it that day. She just checked out. You know, she just came in and did it by the numbers. No, I don't think there's ever been a vocal performance in Chaka Khan's career that was by the numbers. I think she brings that juice to every single thing she sings. And before the episode here, before I went on camera, I was looking at through the list of songs that I have. And my playlist for Chaka Khan is woefully understocked. Okay, I don't have nearly enough of her stuff in my personal music database here. But just looking at the variety of material and the number of incredible vocal performances, and then listening to some of those vocal performances, and you're going to hear another one here when we get to the best is yet to come here in a second. Just an unbelievable singer. What a voice, what chops, what technique, what soul, what passion. I mean, these are the words I just keep repeating over and over. And I have loved me some Chaka Khan for a very long time, and was fortunate to see her in concert here about 10 years ago when she first sort of started kind of busting out and coming back a little bit, coming back to performing. And so I was fortunate to see her in concert, thanks to a good friend of mine that took me to that show. I have a world of respect for Chaka Khan, and I think she is an absolute monster vocal talent. And I was looking at her playlist, and there's five songs I could have played just as easily today, but I really want you guys to hear, since I mentioned the thing about her being a jazz singer at heart, that's my secret, I think that. Since I mentioned that, I want you to hear her singing this standard. And I don't know what else can you say. I mean, when you hear this and hear how she works this song. And first of all, of course, the best is yet to come being a standard. It's been done a million times, and it's been done quite well, almost a million times. So many other artists have done great versions of this great song. And I have probably a half dozen other artists in my collection doing the song, and I love all of those interpretations. But I have to tell you, back there in 2004, when Chaka released this album, I'm not sure I ever heard it done better than this. And when I hear it in my head now, most of the time I'm hearing Chaka Khan's version. From her 2004 album, I'll show you the updated album cover if you want to get this one. I highly suggest it. Fantastic album. So many great songs on this record. Could have played any number of them. The London Symphony Orchestra and the incredible Chaka Khan. Enjoy this one, folks. Listen to this girl sing. The best is yet to come. I believe her. Stop it so early, but for a reason, because I don't want to interrupt any more of this than I absolutely have to. I'm even going to rewind it a little bit to let you guys get the full effect here. But listen how she works these verses. Her voice is such an unbelievable instrument, and there is so much subtlety and nuance and color in her voice. God, and every time I hear her sing, I think the same thing. Listen to her.
The best is yet to come, and baby, won't it be fine? You think you've seen the sun, but you may see it shine. Wait till the warm up's underway. Wait till our till you see that sunshine day, you ain't seen nothing yet. The best is yet to come, and baby, won't
Okay, I said top 10, right? Knocking on top 5. Oh my goodness. I could play, I want so badly right now to play like 3 other songs and just show you how insanely good Chaka Khan is. What a singer. God, and there are some songs that we are going to get to on this channel, and I don't want to mention the albums, I don't want to mention the year, I want to surprise you guys with them when we get to them, and we will get to them sooner than later after I hear this now, just now, and remind myself how much I love and how much I respect Chaka Khan, bringing the passion and bringing the juice and bringing those exquisite vocal abilities to just about everything she does. And I'm telling you, folks, and don't get me wrong, because I love her career just fine the way it is. She has done so much, and as I've said, working those genres, pop, soul, R&B, jazz, she's done just about everything. So I love her career, but I'll tell you, folks, Chaka Khan would have been one hell of a jazz artist. If we were to look back, if she had gone that direction in her career, and we were looking back at her career now from 2022, and she'd been a jazz singer the whole time, she's right there. She is right there in the conversation with the giants, with the ladies that I mentioned there, Billie Holiday and Dinah Washington and Ella and Sarah Vaughan and all of those legends. She is right there. I have no doubt about that. Chaka Khan, and she brings that vocal magic to the soul stuff. And that's what I think makes the soul stuff so come alive so much. I mean, of course, as I said, some of those songs are just epic songs, just incredible songs to begin with. And they would have been great songs no matter who had done them. But she really, I think, just brings that to that quality, the vocal thing, to everything that she touches and injects that passion in. It's just unmistakable. The great Chaka Khan. And of course, you know, she has been on some other albums by other artists. I'm not going to mention any names there. You never know when she might pop up on a duet or something with another artist. That's always a possibility, too. But I'm thinking of a few Rufus songs that, oh my God, I would love to play for you guys. Okay, we'll get to it. That is it for today. Moving in another different direction tomorrow. It's going to be fun to see where we go tomorrow. I've got some good stuff coming down the line here for you guys. I hope you love Chaka Khan, the queen. Man, she is one of those legendary queens out of that era, isn't she? Chaka holding it down every single time. See you guys soon. Chaka Khan, Chaka Khan.